Hi, everybody. This is Miss Gilding. Today we're going to read The Blue Jay Yarn by Mark Twain, abridged from A Tramp Abroad, adapted by Tom and Mary Gilding, illustrated by Robert Marr. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. You may call a blue jay a bird. Well, so he is. He's got feathers on him, but otherwise he is just as much a human as you are. A blue jay can cry, and a blue jay can laugh. A blue jay can plan and discuss. A blue jay has a sense of humor. Animals talk to each other, but I never knew but only one man who could understand them. I knew he could because he told me so himself. His name was Jim Baker. Jim Baker was a kind-hearted miner who lived in the woods and mountains in a lonely corner of California. He studied the ways of his only neighbors, the beasts and the birds. Jim Baker believed he could understand any words animals said. He told me that some animals use only simple words. Other animals have a large vocabulary and talk a great deal, showing off their talent. Jim Baker said blue jays were the best talkers among all the animals. Jim Baker told me, the blue jay has got more moods and feelings than any other creature. And whatever a blue jay feels, he puts into his language. A blue jay never gets stuck for a word. They boil out of him just like water out of a pot on a hot stove. Well, anyway, Jim Baker told me this story about blue jays. Jim said, 7 years ago, the last man in my mining camp moved away. There stands his log house with a plank roof. It is just one big room. There is nothing between the floor and the roof. One Sunday, I was sitting in front of my cabin with my cat, looking at the blue hills, when a blue jay landed on that house. The blue jay had an acorn in its mouth. That blue jay said, "Hello, I reckon I have struck something." When that blue jay spoke, the acorn dropped out of his mouth and rolled down the roof. But he didn't care. His mind was on the thing he struck, which was a knot hole in the roof. He cocked his head to one side, shut one eye, and put the other one to the hole, like a possum looking down a jug. His bright eyes gave a wink. He said, "It looks like a hole. Yes, I believe it's a hole." He flew down and picked up the acorn that had rolled down the roof. He dropped the acorn into the hole. He tilted his head and listened, but his smile faded. He said, "I didn't hear it land." He took a long look down that hole. Then he walked around and studied it from every point. He scratched his head. He said, "Well, this must be a mighty long hole indeed." He flew off and fetched another acorn and dropped it in. He tried to flirt his eye to the hole quick enough to see what became of the acorn, but he was too late. He fetched another acorn and did his best to see what became of it, but he couldn't. He walked back and forth on the roof, shaking his head and muttering to himself. He said, "Well, you are a deep hole, but I've started to fill you, and I'm going to fill you if it takes 100 years. With that, away he flew. You have never seen a bird work so hard. He worked for about 2.5 hours. He never even stopped to take a look when he dropped each acorn in the hole. He just dropped them in and went for more. At last, he could hardly flop his wings. He was tuckered out. Sweating like an ice pitcher, he dropped one more acorn in and said, "Now I guess I've got that hole filled by this time." He bent down for a look. When his head came up again, he was pale with rage. No sign of the acorns, not even one. That poor blue jay. He had just enough strength to crawl to the highest part of the roof and lean against the chimney. Just then, another blue jay was flying by and heard him muttering to himself. He flew down and asked, "What is the problem?" The suffering jay told him the whole story and said, "If you don't believe me, Look in the hole yourself. So the other blue jay put his eye to the hole and looked. He said, "How many acorns did you put in there?" "Not any less than 2 tons, said the suffering blue jay. The other jay looked in the hole again. Then he raised a yell. 3 more blue jays came down. They examined the hole and made the suffering jay tell the same story all over again. They discussed the problem. Each gave his opinion, as your average crowd of humans would have done. They called in more blue jays. Then they called in more. There must have been 5,000 blue jays jawing, arguing, ripping, and screeching. Every jay put his eye to the hole and delivered a more chuckle-headed opinion about the mystery than the blue jay that went before him. Now there was one blue jay who decided to look at things from a different angle, you might say. He flew around and examined the house all over. He saw the door standing half open. He flew down, lit on top of the door, and looked in. The mystery was over in a glance. There lay the acorns scattered all over the floor. That blue jay flapped his wings and raised such a whoop. "Come here, everybody," he said. "Hanged if this fool hasn't been trying to fill up a whole house with acorns." The jays all came swooping down like a blue cloud. Each fellow took a glance. There were the acorns scattered all over the floor, hundreds of them. Each blue jay fell over backwards, suffocating with laughter. And then the next blue jay took his place and did the same. Well, those blue jays roosted around on that housetop for an hour, maybe longer. They laughed and laughed about that thing just like human beings would do. You can't say a blue jay doesn't have a sense of humor, because I know better. A blue jay has a very good memory too. They brought jays here from all over the United States to look down that hole. And they could all see the humor of the thing. All the blue jays, that is. Once an owl from Nova Scotia stopped, and he couldn't find anything funny in it at all. But that owl said he was disappointed about the look of Niagara Falls, too. Hit the subscribe button so you never miss a new video. I miss you, I love you, and I'll speak to you soon.